Hello everyone, welcome to update number 4 of the project Taking Toolbox for Creativity to Kickstarter. And yes, I know I am a bit late for this update. I already apologize about this, so I will not waste more time on this. And the first thing I want to say is that, as you can see here on the board, some things changed, but there are some things that remain. And these things are the GON, the game of numbers, as I have called it, and the M words. And the reason I'm bringing your attention to this and to this guy here telling us to stop is because we actually had to stop what we were doing. We had to stop the activities that we were executing just to re-examine the numbers. So the numbers are not so good. So we had to look at our strategy a little bit better. And when I say numbers, I primarily talk about backers. We don't have enough, or we don't have the right number that we should have given the time that we have invested on this project, and that potentially can impact the project negatively when we actually go live on Kickstarter. And second, the money, you know, the amount of time and money spent versus what we hope to get from the people who will back the project. So the numbers are a bit not on our side. We are working on this and we will see how this happens, how this evolves. But what I'm saying is we had to stop a little bit with what we were doing, go back to square one, and look at the numbers in black and white, just at the numbers, you know. And as I said on the previous update, it is essential to look at the numbers because, you know, we fall in love with what we are doing. And sometimes we forget to look at the numbers, you know, like cold hard numbers. Anyhow, but not everything is doom and gloom. There are also good news. And the first good news is that while we started doing this project, Joe Slack was also sharing some really interesting information on how to run a Kickstarter campaign for board games. So let's have a look at this. And here it is, the last email of the series. And as Joe says, this is a series of emails on how to run a Kickstarter board game campaign. And here we have some bullet points, some major components, as he says himself, about how to run a board game Kickstarter campaign. I will be providing the link to the board game design course on my YouTube channel, so you can actually go and follow this directly. The emails are there, and there are quite a few, and they're really, really useful. We're actually using them as a way to construct all the activities needed in order to estimate how long our campaign will last and all the efforts that we need in order to see this through. Something else to mention is that my podcast with Dustin Stats is now live on Board Gaming with Education. And this is episode 125. I believe there is one more out. Nonetheless, mine was episode 125, and we discussed diversity and inclusion in games. Games for education. And yeah, so here it is. It was really cool to see this as well. Going to the Board Gaming with Education page, here we can see the full article, the full podcast, the information about it. So nonetheless, you know, this is a podcast. The picture I think is cool, so I will also leave the link on the YouTube video. So please, you know, if you listen to this, leave a comment, sign to the podcast, and you know, let's make this community a little bit bigger. And something else I want to mention, another positive thing of all this journey, is that I received this prototyping kit from Panda, and it is amazing. I did a little of unwrapping the box on my social media channels, so I hope you saw it. I cannot open it like this because, you know, things fall out, but it's an amazing prototyping kit. One thing though that I wanted to discuss a little bit today is the dice tower that is seen as, you know, it comes in a punch board, sort of flat, and you have to put it together. But when I was putting it together, something kept, you know, bugging me, and I was thinking, so I have two dice, and I was thinking, sure, this dice tower is not doing what it's supposed to do, right? because I just kept putting the dice in and the dice kept coming out. And I was thinking, I think a dice tower is supposed to drop some of the dice and then some of the dice come out, and through this process, randomness is, you know, integrated into the game. And I got this idea from listening to one very early podcast by Jeff Engelson in the Ludology podcast. And that was the first time I heard about, you know, dice towers. And I suppose that idea got into my head. But after watching this dice tower, you know, more and more and more, I realized that randomness is also introduced by using this type of tower that does not drop any dice inside. Simply what it does is shakes the dice. Have you ever played games with somebody who rolls the dice like this and then you want to kill them? Well, I suppose that's the type of randomness that is introduced by using this type of dice, dice tower, because no matter how you throw the dice in here, the dice is shaking as it goes through it, and then the dice come out. So it's kind of fun, and you know, it avoids you from killing these people out there who throw the dice on the board like this. Perfect. So that's all I wanted to say about this Panda, you know, prototyping kit. Thank you very much, Panda. It was amazing. And something that is also worth mentioning, a positive, as I mentioned, that evolved or materialized in the last week, but it's the result of this journey, is that potentially two people agreed to be testers for this game. And testers are really important, but because this game, this learning solution, is aimed at education, learning and development. Education can be in formal education settings like colleges and universities, but also it can be applied to corporate learning. So that's what I was looking for testers this time. The product has been tested in a university. We know it works. It went really, really well. And now I was looking for testers in the corporate environment. And I found two people, and I believe that we are really, really close to finally, you know, agree on how this testing will be done. So that's a positive. They, as I said, they primarily or initially said yes. Now it's just a matter of understanding how we're gonna do this. I have to mail the physical game, the digital elements of the game. Of course, you know, they can just be made available electronically. That's not a big deal, but you know, the logistics need to be coordinated. Hopefully in a couple of weeks, I will have some updates for you on how this went, but it's good news so far. And finally, I just want to share with you a lesson learned that about Kickstarter. So first of all, in order to pre-launch your project, the project needs to be approved. And so here we have a finish to start sort of relationship that until you finish one, the next one cannot be started. We didn't know this. We thought, following some of the, you know, videos and advice that is available online about how to get the pre-launch page, that it was supposed to be quite simple. It's not. You actually need to complete all the information about your project. That is actually on an email that Kickstarter sent to me in reply to my question, because I just wanted to know what are the minimum elements that they need in order to, you know, review and approve the project. Well, they need everything. Whatever is on the page, all the five sections, they need to be blue or green, whatever color represents that is completed. Once you have that, the project will go for review, and after they review it, then you can do the pre-launch. So that's the lesson learned that I wanted to share with you, because, you know, I heard sort of different information, as I said, in other social media channels and YouTube videos explaining how to do this. And in this case, I do have an email from Kickstarter telling me that everything is needed. So everything is needed in order to get to pre-launch, to submit the project for review, to get it approved, and then to go for pre-launch. And that is all for today. I think it was a short update, but still had some valuable information, useful, I should say. If you are running a Kickstarter campaign for games for learning and development, or for products and services for learning and development. So thank you very much. Thank you for listening. I hope you found this useful. If you want to subscribe and see how this project evolves, go ahead and click subscribe. And yes, I'll see you next week. Actually, I should be making the next update in 4 days. So hopefully I will see you in 4 days. Thank you, bye.